It is of supreme importance
that we get our image of Jesus
right. For there are too many blithering idiots,
well-meaning people,
religious schismatics,
church leaders,
Marxists,
Tories,
anarchists,
establishment figures,
who are leading people astray. So listen carefully. Jesus,
as we all know,
came from a model family.
His mother was pregnant when she got married
and lived in a secure home.
They were refugees.
As the old hymn says, throughout his wondrous childhood,
about which we know next to nothing,
he was mild and obedient.
He did bunk when he was 12.
Jesus was the model working man.
He became redundant when he was 30.
Encouraging entrepreneurship in others.
He told Peter, Andrew, James, John, Matthew to give up their jobs.
He kept good company.
Dining with beggars and prostitutes.
He had a good word for everybody.
Vipers, blind guides, hypocrites.
His conversation was about the finer things in life.
Doe, sheep, pig farming, wise virgins.
He never dabbled with controversy.
He just claimed to be the Son of God.
Jesus never upset anyone by his language.
Except priests, Pharisees, pigeon sellers, executioners, and wealthy young men.
He was respected in religious circles.
He wanted to lynch him after his first sermon.
Jesus was a man among men.
And women.
He was a man of God.
He was the Son of God.
In majesty, we see God at work.
In his humility, we meet God in person.
That's why he was worshipped.
That's why he was crucified.
Jesus isn't here now.
He rose again on the third day.
So we have to get on with it ourselves.
He sent his Holy Spirit to guide us.
We have to build the kingdom.
We have to celebrate his presence among us.
We have to give a lead.
We are to follow where he calls.
Stand up and be counted.
Humbly.
Like soldiers.
As servants.
We are a mighty army.
We are the body of Christ.
It is of supreme importance
that you get our image of Jesus
right.